Hello everyone, this is Gaius, and I'm back from the RainbowCraft server. And today, I feel like every time I record is an exciting day, but this is also very, very, very exciting. I think it's the most exciting I've been for days, because I've been working on this for about 3 weeks now. Started during the Christmas by building what you see behind me there, the fuel production station for the fusion reactor. And I built the fusion reactor. I've given you a tour of that already. And I ended that because that work stopped because I needed to store all the energy that the fusion reactor is going to build or make. And then we needed induction cells, and those required a really huge amount of resources to make, because I wanted a big one. And the fun bit is, we are now done, because it took at least a couple of weeks for our farms to produce enough resources, enough gold and iron specifically. And when I finally set the thing to build, I'm gonna show you. I finally ordered up the thing, because I set up ME system to program it so it will build it for us. But when I finally set up the build, it just wasn't huge enough, big enough to handle it. The processing units were these type. I had 8 of these. They weren't big enough to handle it. So I made this. And that also took quite some time to get enough resources to do. well, not enough resources to set it up to produce it. So that also took a little work. Once that was done, I pushed the go button for our 190 induction cells, ultimate induction cells. And that was pretty much 24 hours ago that I pushed the production there. It's been running non-stop for 24 hours, and it was just finished. It's insane. So it's taken a lot of time, you know, in processing. Mostly that time's gone to processing, because I think I've made processes about, a quarter of a million of each of gold and iron and redstone and coal have gone in all of the production. But now we have 190 induction cells. And what's going to be really, really annoying now is that it proves to be too little. So let's go down. Wait. Oh, okay. I was wondering why I wasn't getting the... Let's just put this back on as well. There we go. Night vision enabled. There's our fusion reactor. There's its fuel. And while I'm building this, I'm going to enable the laser that's going to fire the whole thing. So you see, it's quite loud. But it's now charging. Spit the laser amplifier here. I'm gonna run it just as long as we have power. The reactors behind that wall there are now running full. And then we need to fill this bit. Oh my, this is lagging me a bit. Okay. Hang on, I have a builder's wand. That. I think the... Oh, it is noisy. I think it's gonna... Yep, there we go. Our production isn't large and stable enough to hold, run this more than a little bit at a time. But, you know, I think this should be enough. So let's get back to building the induction cell. And when I did the calculations on this, if I remember correctly, I've forgotten the results now because it's been so long ago. It's literally 3 weeks ago. But I think it was something like 38 billion RF that it can store. And if you think that sounds like a lot, it is a lot. Right now, the RF per tick use and, you know, when just running the things that need to run is about 40 for our entire thing. 40,000 RF per tick. And, okay, so that's... Oh, shoot, that was stupid of me. Okay, I need to place these in before I... I can do it. I just reached. Brilliant. Yeah, so we have about 40,000 RF per tick to run on all the things that we have right now. And that's running off of three reactors, two in the other room here, and one in orbit. Oh, you need to fill in this as well. And that's it, done right there. And I did miscalculate, but in a way that we are quite happy with. I have three too many. And that's good. That's very good. And we close it off, and it is done. It is so done. 187 cells. Okay, 26 million RF. Okay, so my calculations were a bit off, but, you know, it's good. 10 by 8 by 6, that sounds about right. There you have the cryo-stabilized flux duct, which is the most powerful thing that we have. Not entirely sure what this is. Yes, this is probably to fill in, and then this is probably to just take things out. Ooh, I'm going to test that with a basic capacitor once we're done. And the other thing that we need to do is bring out the hall arm. Because from what I understand now, this does have the deuterium and tritium fuel lines. We have the charge set up. And all we need to do now is put the hall arm in there. I think. Okay, yeah, I need to... Where did your injection rate... 2, maybe? I think. Statistics, fuel, heat. Alright. Just to be safe, we're going to run this a little on. To check. Why the lag? I'm gonna go off and check this bit. See it? Wait. What's going on? Why aren't you. Okay, this one's all depleted, but that's what it usually is. Ah, there we are. It's now reacting. Because it's draining it completely there. It's completely drained. And that means it's now running at almost full capacity. That's almost, is it 25, so 55, so 65. I know the one in space is around 10K RF per tick. Right, see, how much did that get us up to? It was up to 289. Let's turn output off. Let's put. Alright. You know what? I'm going to try this. I'm definitely going to try this. I don't want to stand Maybe I want to stand so we can see this best. I think this is where we want to stand. Oh, right there. There. Yeah, this is the place. Let's hit this. Hopefully this all goes well, and hopefully I don't die. I have no idea how, if that's a possibility, but, you know, there's a lot of power involved here. I mean, we've stored 289 million RF in this bit now, in the laser amplifier. I'm a bit nervous, to be honest, but, you know, here goes. Well, that was anticlimactic. Emptied out the thing and nothing happened. Are you kidding me? What happened? Why did it not do the thing? Oh, the plasma wasn't hot enough. Okay, minimum injection rate, 2 ignition temperature, 100 million Kelvin. I definitely don't have enough power. So, I'm guessing we are going to have to charge this again. So, I'm going to turn this on, I think. No, off. Yes. Hi. Yeah, I think this is the bit. Then we need to charge it up again. That's what we're doing right now, right? Yep, story. So this will have to run for days, I'm guessing. Can consume all our energy production for a long time now. So, yeah. Brilliant. Hang on, let me check a little thing. Okay, so that was not helpful. Yeah. So, yeah. It's gonna have to charge for a bit, and I'll, you know, get back to you. Okay, I've been checking this a bit now, and it seems I misread a few things for the first time. Shush. First of all, this had to be charged all the way up. I thought maybe 100 would be enough, so I thought that if I charged it up to 300, it would be more than enough. But that was, I think it was 100 or 200 Kelvin of heat was the thing. So I've been running this all day, charging it up to 2 giga RF. Completely full right now, so it's ready to shoot. Another thing I discovered was the fuel injection rate. This is the minimum for an air cooled reactor, and I that's what I've got on an air cooled reactor. I'm supplying deuterium and tritium separately and then let it out of there, but in order to start it, it has to be injection rate 6, and then you can adjust it up or down. I'll write it later. I think I'm going to adjust it up, but just 6 to start it up. This bit, the heat, is what we have to look at. This is what is at the air cooled minimum injection rate 2. Ignition temperature 100 millikelvin. This is what the thing that I got, thought. This is the does it passive generation 600,000 RF per tick. Yeah. Okay, so this is lower temperature, lots of steam, which I guess then is used. I have no idea how to do this bit, so I'm doing the air cooled. This is probably what it alone generates, and then the steam bit probably does something else. I'm going to, you know, look at that later. Right now I'm going to try and do this. So the whole home is As I said in a previous video, Hohlraum is a German word for basically hollow room or void. It's filled with DT fuel, ready for reaction. So we're ready. Hohlraum is there. Injection rate is 6. We have the fuel supplied. This thing is completely something. This has. It got 144 million RF while for the short time that it was stored there. So let's start this. Let's try this again. No, I'm gonna want to stand over here. Let's go watch it. Okay, 3, 2, 1, boom. And it started. It started! Look at this! This is our new fusion reactor up and running. Let's have a look at this first. How is this doing? It's producing 650,000 RF per tick. Filling up very quickly. Let's look at this. It's formed. All of them is spent. Just have to use that. Plasma is running. Casing is running. I have no idea what happens next. If this shit blows up, then I'm gonna be so pissed. Okay, so that's it. Where's the statistics? So no, that was that's not statistics, that's just, you know, something else. The fuel is being used. Hopefully it's not being used at a larger rate than we can really produce it, because if this goes down to zero, it shuts down. So we're going to let this run for a few days and see what happens. See, it's now at 500 million RF, 600, almost 600 million RF. And it's not even showing on this, so we can. Oh, actually, now it is 600 million RF. See, it's filling up really quickly. So these statistics. Yeah, 26,000. Wait, what? It does 600,000 RF per tick, and now it's 680,000 a million RF. Well, the statistics say. Oh, it's the input, so the max output could actually be 26 million RF per tick. That is absolutely insane. Huh. That's absolutely insane. So yeah, I think this should be able to contain, I think it was around 40 billion RF when it's done. I wonder how this is faring. So this is transferring, if I'm judging this right, then the production here, come on, shouldn't I be able to see the production at some point? Statistics for 600. Yeah, it's a bit annoying that I can't see the actual production here. I really wish I could see that. Can I right click this? No. Okay, ignore that. Yeah, but it looks like this, the cryostabilized flux duct, is transferring power as quickly as it's produced into here. There's a bit of a visual glitch there. It's a bit weird, because the reason that's weird is because I said it takes it out that way and into this way. It probably wouldn't need to, but you know, I did that anyway. Up to 1 giga RF. Wow. So this thing is running. It looks really funky. Like I said, I'm going to run this for a day. Because I'm really interested in seeing how this fares. The injection rates there. So I might check up some. Look up on the internet. Look on Google.
with, like, if there's a, if it ever, what the injection rate does in the production. I did see some numbers, and it suggested from what I saw those numbers, I might have a not good enough production of RF in order, no, for fuel. Oh, come on, get in there. I've taken off the things. Get in there. What the hell? Why? Fine, screw it. I'll go around. Out this way. I'm very interested in the production bit over here now. A bit like that. I'm not worried about this. This transfers quite quickly. This produces as quickly as we can pump it out, I know. This one is, I don't remember the transfer rate, but it's very, very high. So then we're down to this bit, and it produces 62 millibuckets per tick at quite a high temperature. It only produces during the day, though, that's a bit of a trouble. This one should have the same, 61, 62, 62, yeah, it's about the same. Should be the same. So that produces brine and sends it into this bit, which also produces 62 millibuckets per tick, but it compresses this. Oh my, this is where we'll see the thing. Brine is going down faster than it's going up. So that's troubling. Water is going down as up and down as quickly. Up as quickly as going down. So that's good. But the brine, which means the production is too low. Brine production is too low. Huh. So what happens when this reaches zero? That's the question. Because then this then goes into here with the rotary concentrator. And it's producing at a steady rate. Can't get over there. How about this way? Ah, I can't see that. I need to go out. That's very thoughtless. You know what? I'm going to portable hole my way out there. Let's have a look at these. These are producing as fast as they are getting. I think that bit's right. I think, come on, I was just too late. Let's get through again. Need to put a door there. So this bit is then producing it didn't say anything about the production rate. Someone has measured that. I'm going to look into that bit. It might be that this brine is going down quick, so this will be the moment of truth when it, wait, it's going up again. Wait, what? It goes up at night? That's weird. Production zero. That's what's going on. This one has production zero. This one's still producing. That's interesting. So brine production keeps going, but the lithium production has dropped to zero. This one should be going. This one's not. Yes, it's using 6 RF per tick. 6 RF per tick sounds a bit low, doesn't it? Given it all the speed and energy upgrades. Lithium production. And then the tritium there. How about the deuterium? Yeah, this one's good. Goes up and down about as quickly as it can. So this one's good. So this one has insufficient production, but it's the lithium production and the tritium production that I'm a bit worried about right now. Might have to put up some buffers there. Anyway, so I'm going to run this bit for a yeah. Okay. Oh, let me just quickly remove my helmet there. So, this has been... that's a thing. It's dark down here. Put up the lights. So, this has been a bit interesting episode. It's a long way coming. This is definitely an end game power source. 600,000 RF per tick is insanely long, because up until now we've been producing about 60,000 RF per tick. So it's basically 10 times as much per tick in production. So this is, even though this probably isn't optimal right now, it's now more energy than we've ever needed. Might not be more than we'll ever need, but you know, I could now perhaps replace the ridiculous wind turbines on planets with and moons and bases with tesseracts, and instead power everything with this. But we'll see. I'll have to run it first before I let it in anywhere near our grid. But I have set up a way to get power out of this induction cell. I hope you enjoy this maybe a bit boring episode, but I thought it was very exciting. It's taken so much time to get here. It's taken a lot of resources to build this thing, a lot of studying, a lot of reading up on things, testing things to just build it, and it took pretty much forever to get the resources to get the induction cell and enough energy to just get it started. So this has been quite an interesting adventure, and it'll be interesting to see where we go from here. I really hope this will be stable and can generate passively 600,000 RF per tick. So, hope you've enjoyed, and we'll be back with an update later. Hopefully, not very soon. Bye!